Hey guys, today we're talking the updates for Microsoft in June of 2023. So definitely comment below with the feature or functionality you're most excited about. We'll be walking through a lot of Teams updates as well as Microsoft Intune today. So let's go ahead and dive in.
Okay, so before we get into it here, just a quick reminder that I do supplement these videos with a blog post down below with more information about all these announcements, including setup guides, video tutorials, things like that. So definitely check out that after you watch this video. Getting into it here though, we're gonna start off with Microsoft Teams as we usually do. This first one is compact chat list. This is clearly depicted in the screenshot down below here in that middle column where you see you have just a list of your users and it's very compressed in that way. They also mentioned that this is more private because you're not seeing the message preview as part of all these Teams messages going on. So this will happen early June and be complete by late June. So by the time you're watching this video, this might already be available to you. Check the blog post for some steps on how to configure this. The next one here is related to Apple CarPlay, and this is specifically integrating more of an experience with the Teams app within Apple CarPlay. So you can see that you have the speed dial and history of your contacts there within the experience. And that will have support for any vehicle that supports Apple CarPlay. This will be mid-July and be complete by early August. Next one here is related to Teams Rooms and the Teams panel. This, as you can see in the left-hand screenshot, is allowing you to be able to scan a QR code with your mobile device in the mobile Teams app. And from there, as you can see in the right-hand screenshot, you're able to reserve the room for an existing meeting you already have on your calendar, or you can schedule a new meeting and book that room. So it's a pretty cool experience. This will happen early August and be complete by early September. Next one here is related to search within the Microsoft Teams Admin Center. I think anything that improves search is always a good experience, especially for something like Microsoft Teams and just Microsoft features in general because they change where they're located all the time. This is giving you better search capabilities across a wide range of entities, and this will happen late June, be complete by mid-July. And then the other one that I have listed here is group chat message copy links, which is specifically saying that you could link to a particular message within a group's chat, and people who have access to that, you'd be able to just deep link them back to that message. So thinking of a message that was a long time ago, you want to resurface it for certain information, just for convenience, be happy to link back to it within your messages and within your posts there. So this will happen early July and be complete by the end of August. Next one here is related to Teams Mobile. And this is just giving users a better experience to upload files from OneDrive into the mobile chat or a Teams channel for iOS and Android. This will happen late June and it can be complete by mid-July. And then the last one here is always a fan favorite. Just wanted to tuck it in here. We're introducing dark mode to the Teams Admin Center, something you can toggle on and off. And this will happen early June, be complete by the end of June. So by the time you're watching this video, another one where you might have this available to you in the Teams Admin Center. Shifting into Microsoft Exchange here, this is a more forward-looking notice, but this is a great one for me, I think, just because they are removing the native mail and calendar app out of the start menu and replacing it with the new Outlook for Windows application. This isn't going to happen until 2024, so you still have some time for this. But it's a great experience because, number one, for security purposes, you want to use client-protected applications like Outlook, and also reduces confusion for users who are trying to set up their profiles, things like that, on these devices. And then shifting into our last section here, Microsoft Intune. First one I'm very excited about, MAM for Edge on Windows, so mobile application management. If you're familiar with the MAM policies within Intune today for iOS and Android, these are very similar. We have functionalities such as restricting cut, copy, paste to unmanage applications. And as you can see in the screenshot here, you can actually redirect users to a managed browser like Edge if they're in Chrome and trying to access corporate data on a personal device and needing to do that using Edge as the alternative for these types of things. And you can also get very particular with the security settings that are enabled on that device in order to grant or restrict access. So this is out in a public preview you could sign up for. No announcement just yet on general availability. We'll keep you guys updated with that over time. And the last two announcements here relate to Intune. The first one is related to the management of Windows driver and firmware updates in Microsoft Intune. So I touched on this a few months back as far as this being in public preview, but now it's generally available. And the key thing to mention here is that it is subject to a licensing constraint, meaning that you have to have a Windows 10 Enterprise E3 or E5 license enabled to be able to support this functionality and use this functionality within Intune. Last one here is also a cool one, I thought, just intelligent recommendations with Intune security baselines. So if you're familiar with security baselines in Microsoft Intune, it's basically like a blanket level of Microsoft recommended security practices for your Windows devices. And in a lot of cases, it can cause disruption because of the number of security policies that you're really configuring on a device. It could break something at a user level or at a company level, depending on if they have certain line of business applications or whatever it might be. So you really need a much more tailored approach, which is what Microsoft's trying to do here with the machine learning models and getting the device telemetry beforehand to provide better recommendations on the security baselines you should probably push out. It'll still be interesting to see how accurate that is and how it looks, but another one there I thought that was great to bring up. No timelines just yet on this one, but I'll update you guys accordingly in the future. That's everything I have for you guys today in this video. Definitely comment below with any questions or comments. And as always, like and subscribe if you guys want to see more content around Microsoft and the MSP space. Thanks, guys. I'll see you in the next video.